Welcome to Tea with Erping. As we have entered the new year of 2022, many are still trying to figure out their new goals or resolutions for this year of tiger ahead of us. This morning, I found 7 new year resolution proposals from the website of Harvard University. Practice mindfulness and meditation turned out to be the second recommendation, right behind the suggestion of taking a free Harvard course. So let's dive in and explore why meditation is so popular and getting so much attention these days. Due to the global pandemic that is still ongoing with no certainty on what we can expect in the near future, many people that I have come across have been on this seemingly unsettled pedestal state of mind. A few friends who came across my YouTube channel started to ask me, how is it possible that you are staying unstressed during this period of uncertainty and even managing to start a YouTube channel? Let me share with you a little secret from ancient Chinese culture. First, let's talk about one very simple word, tranquility, a simple word that contains deep foundation of truth within our life. Tranquility refers to a state of calmness, undisturbed, unaffected, and free from emotions, a feeling of serenity and peacefulness. Tranquility is often associated with meditation. Those of you who are yoga enthusiasts, Go Green devotees, Hygge, wabi-sabi, or any of those trends of slow living will be quite familiar with this word tranquility. Everyone talks about it, dreams of achieving it, and wishes to reach a higher level of their capability of meditating. Meditation is no longer a new subject, nor a method of unwinding oneself from this hectic and dramatic human life. It has rapidly become a way of life, and plenty of us have found it beneficial to meditate as a part of our lifestyle. Let me walk you through an example. Visitation Valley Middle School in San Francisco was infamous for its students' bad behaviors. The school told the media that students were influenced by the violence in the surrounding neighborhood. To meet these challenges, the school board brought in the Quiet Time Meditation program and designated a portion of the school time to allow students to practice mindfulness. Through this initiative, the school sees fewer student suspensions, increased attendance rates, increased academic and cognitive performance. Principal Bill Copenhagen says he's glad meditation has helped students to find ways to deal with violence, the trauma, and the stress of everyday life. These days, meditation is becoming trendy even in the business sector. Some of the biggest corporations in the world, like Google, Apple, and Nike, have adopted some form of meditation training through what's called mindfulness training. Today, for many people, the goal of meditating is to reach a state of tranquility. Sounds pretty easy? I challenge you to have half an hour of meditation and see how calm and serene you can be. Let me guess, a few minutes pass by as you sit there cross-legged. Random thoughts and worries start to appear, without you realizing it. Your half an hour was filled with sighs and concerns. Oh, how I miss my friends. When will I get to meet them again for tea? I cannot wait for children to get back to their daily school routines. I love my wife or husband, but staying up at home for 24 hours was not what I signed up for this marriage. How I dreamed of another holiday, am I right? Let me share with you some beautiful words of wisdom by 3 different people from different eras. Who knows, it can be our New Year's resolutions. The first one comes from Buddha Sakyamuni, also known as the founder of the Buddhism. Peace comes from within, do not seek it without. The second one comes from a later period of history, far away on another side of the world. It was only from the inner calm that man was able to discover and shape calm surroundings. Quoted from Stephen Gardiner, an English Roman Catholic bishop, who also served as Lord Chancellor during the reign of Queen Mary I of England. The last word comes from the well-known genius of all, Albert Einstein. He said, "Peace cannot be kept by force. It can only be achieved by understanding." Are you seeing the common thread between the three and their wisdoms on tranquility? They know the truth of tranquility, and there's only one way of achieving it. One can never seek tranquility if one's mind is not calm and composed. That's precisely it. That's the secret of ancient Chinese belief that I was talking about. When you can be less worried over little trivial matters that you come across in daily life, and have more compassion over problems that you face, instead of dwelling on it and getting all worked up, tranquility can be quite achievable. Long before our modern society understood and started practicing meditation, it had been a mandatory part of many religious traditions. The earliest records of meditation was found in the wall art of the Indus Valley Civilization, dating back to 5,000 years BC. The image depicted people sitting in meditation posture with crossed legs, hands resting on their knees, and the eyes slightly closed. The word meditation is derived from the Latin word meditatum, which means to think, contemplate, or reflect on. Meditation, which falls under contemplative practice, has always been an integral part of mainstream Judaism. The Book of Genesis and the Hebrew Bible have indications about the practice of meditation. For Christians, meditation is a form of prayer to seek meaning and reflect upon the revelations of God. Meditation is an essential part of Buddhist tradition in the pursuit for enlightenment, which is preceded with moral restraint and character refinement. Patience and perseverance are admirable virtues that can be strengthened through meditation. Historically, meditation practitioners face many tribulations. They are persecuted and stigmatized for economic, social, or religious reasons. Emperor Wuzong of the Tang Dynasty was known for the persecution of Buddhism, ending the great period of Buddhism in China. Faced with a financial crisis, Emperor Wuzong adopted a suggestion from his Taoist advisors to solve the problem by closing Buddhist shrines, seizing the lands and the wealth of monasteries, and sending the monks home. Such a religious persecution is still happening to this day in China. As I mentioned in my earlier episodes, since 1999, the Chinese Communist Party has been persecuting Falun Gong, a meditation practice in the Buddhist tradition. The odd thing, however, is the Chinese government initially promoted Falun Gong for its health benefits. In fact, the Chinese authorities have showered Falun Gong meditation with numerous awards because of its contribution to public health. In an interview with the US News & World Report in 1999, an official of China Sports Commission said, "Falun Gong and other types of Qigong can save each person 1,000 yuan in annual medical fees. If 100 million people are practicing it, that's 100 billion yuan saved per year in medical fees. Premier Zhu Rongji is very happy about that. The country can use the money right now." Longtime China watchers hold that the Chinese Communist Party feels threatened by the size of its followers, estimated at 70 to 100 million people, and by the revival of the traditional spiritual culture. Outside China, millions are practicing its traditional meditation freely in Taiwan and elsewhere. Here in America, many universities have Falun Gong clubs offering free workshops, such as at Columbia University in New York City and at MIT, where I used to meditate when I was a student at Harvard. As history has shown us, persecution cannot destroy the good and the true. As the Bible says, blessed are those who are persecuted because of their righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. You ask me, what are the benefits of meditation? Why would one take up meditation when it's easier to see a psychiatrist, or take medication to solve our health and life situation? How can a few minutes of sitting every day affect one's overall temperament and behavior? Well, according to research by Harvard scientists, they found observable changes in people's brain size and brain content after a period of meditation. Studies have proven that meditation helps reduce stress and depression. With the great uncertainties we are currently facing in this pandemic, stress and depression crawl uninvited. Before you know it, you are restless, lethargic, and get easily upset for the tiniest mishap. Professor Sarah Lazar from Harvard Medical School started looking at meditation when she was using yoga to recover from an injury. When she realized how much meditation impacted her life, she began looking at the effects of meditation through a scientific lens. In neurological studies, she found that long-term meditators had much more gray matter in the region of brain that dealt with learning and memory. In some cases, she actually found that 50-year-old meditators had the same amount of gray matter as 25-year-old. What's more interesting was her group's finding that many test subjects' cortical thickness actually increased after a few weeks of meditation training, which meant they probably had better cognitive abilities and general improvements in intelligence. The capability to control anxiety comes from the training of the mind, as you need to be in a calm state when you meditate. Eventually, you might get used to being in this state of serenity. It improves emotional health. As of current, you may notice that the verdict of people saying that they are facing mental health issues is of abundance. What exactly are mental health issues, one may ask? The labels are widely used for almost all the wrong reasons. You don't get to hear this issue back in the day, simply because many people have gotten to the point of overindulging in fleeting pleasures and exaggerating any feelings they feel. Instead of handling the little problem they face within them, they point to the outer world. When treated unkindly, they go straight to their endless tunnel of self-pity and blame others. Our ancestors believe in self-restraint, and that's one good practice. Meditation enhances mindfulness. Mindfulness occurs when our mind stops generating useless and distracting thoughts and comes to bear fully and often silently on whatever is right before us. Researchers now know that mindfulness is a calm, natural state with many associated health benefits, including improved immunity and self-esteem, lower chronic pain, and reduced risk factors for cancer and heart disease. According to research, it does this by shrinking the amygdala, or brain's fight or flight center. A better sleep, who wouldn't want that? A simple good night's sleep is easily attainable after you meditate. As you reach tranquility and your heart beats slower, the state of peace beats any sleeping pills and is the best preparation for snooze land. The secret is as simple as to be a calmer person who does not get easily agitated over emotional turmoils when faced with problems in our daily lives, and see if you can manage to excel in this challenge of having tranquil mind during meditation. Lao Tzu once said, "To the mind that is still, the whole universe surrenders." Whether you seek inner peace or enlightenment, meditation nourishes the mind in the same way that food nourishes the body. With the tranquility from daily meditation, may the year ahead be filled with bountiful blissfulness. And of course, drinking tea does wonders to the soul. Until next time, peace and tea be with you.